So, as you can see, I like to use a lot of different colors and varieties of types of yarn. Like this is kind of a thin Vanna yarn that's just got a nice gold thread through it. And then this is some crewel yarn, which you can either use with the two ply together or you can separate it. And then this is a little bit thicker sparkly yarn that it's more of a worsted weight yarn. So I'm just going to show you with the worsted weight yarn, because it's the thickest one, how to thread your needle. So first of all, you're going to want to use a nice big tapestry needle with a big eye in it like this. This one has a slight point on it. Some of them are very dull. I like to have just a little bit of a point. It helps get through the fabric better. So then what you do is you take the yarn and you kind of unwind it a little bit so you can make it flatter. And hold it down with your finger and then push it on top of the needle and then try and make it as flat as you possibly can. See, you can see it here. And then pull it off and then just kind of push it through the hole of the needle. You can also use those little needle threaders, but sometimes they break and stuff, so I just find it easier to do it that way. So that's how you thread a needle. All right, well, I'm not going to start with the black first. I just want to show you with the thicker yarn how to do it. Instead, I'm going to start, get it off of here, with some of this nice sparkly gold yarn. I like to use lots of different colors because I don't know if you've ever noticed with human hair and with animal hair that we have a lot of variation in the color of our hair. So this makes him look more natural. I'm just going to pull out a pair of scissors. So I'm going to cut a fairly long piece here because you're going to want it to dangle off so you can trim it. And I think I'll cut it long enough so I can do two or three different ones. You want to make it too long because then it'll start to tangle on you, and that's kind of a pain in the butt. All right, I'm going to go ahead and thread this one. This is a little easier because the yarn is thinner. Alright, so I'm not going to knot it. If you want to knot the ends of your yarn, there is a tutorial on the pattern at the part where I start doing this where you can knot it. I just find that it kind of sticks up and it doesn't really look very natural. So I'm going to kind of start down here at the snout, and I'm just kind of going to try and go up the midline of the face as best as I can. It's not going to be perfect. And then I'm just going to start adding some yarn here. So I'm going to leave it hang. So it's sort of like almost like a mustache hanging down here. And we're going to trim it shorter later once we get all of our yarn on here. And I'm just going to kind of go in different spots here so that we get different colors in different areas. You don't want to just load it all up in the same place. Make sure that it's fairly long here. Trim it off. Go up and do here some up the top of the head. Trying to keep your midline as best you can. Make sure it's fairly long. Trim it off. So now that I've got a fair amount of hair on here, I'm going to stop for a minute and I'm going to sew on the eyes, and then I'm going to embroider the nose. So first what I'm going to do is kind of clip the hair out of the way, just so that it's not in my way while I'm sewing. Sometimes you can get your threads stuck in everything. I'll just clip it onto his ear like that, kind of get it up out of the way. Let's do this on the other side, just kind of twist it and clip it up there. I'm just using a little hair clip for that. And then just kind of pull these out of the way. Well, first I'm going to sew on the eyes, so I think I'll pull these down. So I'm going to take a regular needle and thread it with some black thread. And then I have these little shank buttons for the eyes. I just bought these at a fabric store. Okay, so now that I've sewn on the eyes and the nose, I'm going to go ahead and unclip this, and I'm going to add some more hair just to give them a nice full head of hair here. I'm just going to kind of comb this down so I can see where I need to add hair. You want to add hair anywhere you've got holes or where you want to make it look a little thicker. And I'm going to go back to using all the different colors, although I'm probably going to stick a lot with this lighter color to match his ears, but I'm going to still use some of the other colors as well. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to start trimming his hair around his face. So now his face is finished. In the next tutorial, I'm going to teach you how to do the hair on his legs and his back. So happy hooking, and don't forget to subscribe. Bye.